Welcome to Analytics with Nux. In this video, we are going to see about how to create a relationship in Power BI. And if you are looking for what is a model tab in Power BI, and this is the video for you. Let's explore our business here scenario. There is a business owner of Naga Garments selling men's casual, ladies casual, and accessories. And we have built a quick dashboard for him as well. Using this example business, we are exploring the Power BI. And today's topic is all about creating relationship, meaning like data won't be available in a single table or single file. It will come from different places as well as people maintain in different tables. So how to relate these tables is the main agenda of this video. Let's see it in action by a demo. We have built this dashboard, and this is based on a single sheet data. From this sheet, it contains sales date, order number, receipt number, selling price, item quantity, everything. Now, the Naga Garments has another table called Item Master, which contains category name, parent band, and cost price of these items. Now he wants to see the parent brand wise the sales data, how much it has sold. For that, he need to relate the data table and the item master table. That is the main agenda of this video. Let's see how we can implement this in Power BI. We already brought the first table, the data table. We need to get the second table now, the item master. Let us get it from here. I'm navigating to the file. Now I need this table. Just ensure it's our required table. Then load it. So it has loaded now. We got two tables now. Let's explore the model tab. Now you see a data table and item master table. Now, before creating a relationship, I want to explain certain things here. Let us take this chart and put it in a new page. Okay. Now, this chart is from data table, where you can see item amount, item name is used in this chart, item name wise, total amount, that is sales amount. Now, let me take the parent brand in pie chart with something like how many items in this brand, okay? Just I will say count of item. So in unbranded, there are three items, in Levi's, four items, and in Peter England it is three items. So it is between, this data is from this particular item master. Okay, so now when I click on Levi's, there is nothing is happening in this chart. So that is the important thing you need to notice, because these two tables are not related. This chart, item amount by item name, is from data, and item count of name by parent brand is from item master. So these two charts are from different tables, and Power BI doesn't know by default this item Levi's belongs to this. You need to explicitly create a relationship. Once we create a relationship, then we can see what happens. So before that, just explore this data. You have data here. What happened? It takes a while. It's okay. Okay, so now how to relate? So for tables to relate, you need some joining column to relate, a common column between these two tables. Now I found item name in this data, and item master, you have this name. both are common column. Using that only we can join. So go to model tab, then I can drag and drop my relationship like this. Then immediately you see the magic here, one star, meaning one item in this table having many records in this table. That is the meaning of it. That is one to many. Okay, let us discuss this more about in later videos. Now let us see our report. Earlier you see when I click on Lewis, it doesn't filter. Now you see when I click on Lewis, it filtered. So these are the three items belonging to Lewis. Okay, forget about this, it is little confusing, but if you see the Excel, in Lewis I have four items: jeans Lewis, jeans denim Zara Lega. Okay, those things are listed here: jeans Lewis, Zara Lega. Okay, another item as well, Zara and Lega. So that is what very important. When you see here, when I click on Peter England, this is specific to Peter England, is filtered. And when you click on unbranded, this specific to unbranded is filtered. So only if you create this relationship, the data will be filtered. And one more, this is the main concept behind relationship. Another important factor I want to highlight is, like, you see the arrow mark over here. This is flowing from this direction, that is item master to this. What it indicate, what it means, let's see. When I click on this, this item is filtered, whereas when I click on this, this won't filter, meaning this arrow mark indicates whatever you do the filter in item master, that will filter your data, I mean data in another table, that is in this table. Okay, so when I, the vice versa won't work, meaning if you do any filter over here, this won't work, this filter won't work. That is what it is. So when you do any action here from the data table, item master data won't be filtering. In some cases you need to do it. So what needs to be done? Let us see that. So you basically, instead of dragging and dropping, you can manage a relationship. Here also you can create new relationship instead of drag and drop. Now let us see edit. So here already you need to create, while instead of dragging and dropping, if you want to create relationship, you need to choose the first table and click on the column, and you need to choose the second table and click on the column to relate. Okay, then here there is an option called cross filter. Okay, here you need to choose both. Forget about this for now, just both, then click close. Now you see there are bi-directional. Okay, if you have any filters in item name, then this will also filter. Let us see it in action. So as you see, like when you filter last time, this doesn't filter. Now this filtered. Okay, creating a relationship not only filters the data. When we see before, clicking on it will see the data over here. Even you can see the data for the brands which is available in the item master with the item amount. What I'm trying to say is, let me remove this count name. Instead, I can view the data by item brand here. Okay, that is what it is. So you can view the data from parent brand of how much it has sold from another table, the item amount. This happened only if you create relationship. Okay, to understand more about it, when we don't have relationship, what happens? Let us see an example. So this is my total amount. Okay, 986650. Let me put it in this data card, item amount. Okay, that is 986 is rounded off to 987k. When I remove the relationship, okay, what happens to the parent brand item amount? Item amount is from data table. Let me delete it. So the total, the 986650, the total amount is repeated for each and every item in this table. So this 98665 is from the item amount from the data table, is repeated for all the items. It doesn't know the split, it doesn't know the relationship. So this is another important factor. If you know, if you find any issues like that, the amount is repeated for all the items in another table, then immediately you can think like there is no relationship between the table. So this is very important concept in Power BI. Without creating a relationship, you can't able to achieve many things. Okay, I hope you guys understand the concept of relationship. If you like this video, please share with your friends and subscribe to this channel if you haven't done it yet. And do remember that data is your asset.